President today set forth the outline of a tentative plan for financing further British purchases in this country, which may be submitted to Congress early next month. Rejecting proposals of loans or of outright cash gifts to the British, he suggested that further British munitions orders in this country might be taken over by the United States government, which would pay the manufacturers and then let the British have the goods. Theoretically, however, the guns and planes and shells and so on would only be leased to the British or perhaps sold subject to mortgage. Details of this have not been worked out, but the President suggested that after the war they might return to us what is left and replace what is lost. The plan apparently also includes the use of surplus American merchant shipping with British crews and under the British flag. But this also would presumably be on the basis of lease or mortgage. However, the President said that the question of title to the property would be a matter for lawyers to straighten out. Mr. Roosevelt added that he saw no need to extend the present limited emergency status by proclamation of a full emergency. Secretary Hull also told public officials today that production must be increased as the British would face the crisis in the first half of next year. And the same point was made tonight by Lord Beaverbrook, British Minister of Aircraft Production, who told his people in a broadcast that they were much too confident and that they would have to expect an attempt at invasion by land and sea, but especially by air, before next spring. Meanwhile, the British are attacking Bardia, the Italian advanced base in Libya, where Marshal Graziani's army is making a vigorous stand in forts surrounding the town. Three forts to the south of Bardia were taken today, however, and the British say that their motorized columns are striking in the rear of the Italian positions and endeavoring to encircle them. The Italians report only that the battle is continuing fiercely, and they claim to have torpedoed a British light cruiser which was bombarding Bardia. It was reported in Athens tonight that the Greeks had taken the town of Tepeleni, though the Italians still hold the heights just beyond, but this is not officially confirmed. The Greeks do officially claim the capture of the strategically important Mount Skivovik between Tepeleni and Kimara, and they say they repulsed several desperate Italian counterattacks in that area. But apparently one of them was not repulsed, for the announcement in Athens that the Greeks are bombarding the port of Palermo, which they captured several days ago, indicates that the Italians have retaken it. No air raids have been reported from anywhere in England tonight, which is presumably due to the heavy fog over the Channel. British bombers, however, were able to take off and are making another vigorous attack on the French Channel forts. Last night, the British attacked Mannheim on the Middle Rhine, where the Germans admit considerable damage, though as usual, they say that hospitals suffered most of it. Some of these British bombers, however, appear to have got 100 miles off their course and raided the Swiss city of Basel, where several persons were killed. The Swiss government has protested and demanded compensation. In London, it is offered in excuse that Basel has been blacked out like German cities on the demand of the Germans, who were afraid its lights might guide British raiders. British air raid casualties for November were about 4,600 killed and 6,200 seriously wounded, making a total of killed and wounded for the year of more than 46,000. Pierre Laval was released from custody today on the demand of Otto Abetz, the German ambassador to France, and took part in a conference this afternoon with Marshal Pétain and the leading members of his cabinet. Abetz has now left Vichy, presumably to report to Hitler, and it is not yet known whether the Germans have demanded that Laval be restored to his former standing. But Berlin's spokesman said today that Germany was determined to examine the motives behind his removal. And that's the news to this moment.